of the things that I noticed working in hospital settings was that there are two words you can't say. You can't use the word love. You can't really say that you love your patients or your clients, because that would be considered unprofessional, or it would be considered transference. And you can't talk about sexuality, or at least it's very much, it might be alluded to, but it couldn't be directly addressed as a practitioner, as a clinician. Part of it is our culture just doesn't have the language to be able to express and address that level of our own humanity.
I am a sex expert and a sex coach. I really believe what's so important right now is that we break the taboo around sex. Sometimes I feel like I'm the freak, but here I am with scientists and doctors.
I want to talk about emotional bioresonance and oxytocin. Oxytocin is the hormone that causes contractions when a woman's in labor, but it's also the hormone of love and attachment. It's controversial whether there is a G-spot.
Where we're blocked around our sexuality, we're blocked in every part of our lives. And part of the issue is people act like life is here and their sex life is here. But really, that breakthrough we need to have is understanding that those two things are inseparable.
Nipple stimulation activates the genital sensory cortex. And this is probably the basis for why nipple stimulation is described as erotic.
Like the hand and like the foot, it has reflexology points that correspond to the major organs. That correspond to the five elements. We also have those same reflexology points on our sexual organs. The man's penis has a kidney point, a liver point, spleen point, heart point.
A need is creating is an imperative, right?
Because it's everything is communication. Our body is communication. Our sexuality is communication. Our body is the imprint of emotion. Quadriplegics who have no sensation below their necks can orgasm by touching their ear.
It's a very particular peak sensation.
Magnesium is very calming at the receptors and will calm the nervous system tremendously, and as well as N-acetylcysteine, omega-3, and many others.
The body is an ecosystem, so some influences may be biochemical, nutritional, and others more movement-based, connective tissue-based. So I like nutrition and movement. They're huge. They're very, very important.
Like even wanting these things, even wanting quality sex, or letting their partner know that the sex that they're having is not quality, I find those...
In the anterior vaginal wall, where the G spot, quote, is located, it's a convergence of a number of different erotogenic areas.
Sex doesn't exist in a bubble, you know, and it's like the microcosm of the macrocosm. And what shows up here is showing up in your life. It's like your approach to life is also going to be your approach to sex. There's no differentiation. So if you're leading a life like this and you're all adrenalized, it's gonna show up in your sex life.
And it's certainly inspiring to have these conversations, not just for the fun of it, but because it's time to do it now. We can't really afford to not have these conversations anymore. There's too many negative ramifications of just ignoring and putting sexuality in a back room. It needs to be discussed in medical schools. It needs to be discussed in grand rounds. It needs to be brought into education, and we can all benefit. Every person can benefit from this information, this array of perspectives.